there. Boom, look at that. So today I'm going to be talking about high fives, the cultural phenomenon. I'm going to be giving you three different points about them. I'm going to be talking about a little bit of an introduction to the high five, a little bit about what the act is. I'm going to be talking about how it's carried out around the world and kind of just the progression of how it's moved on through time. And then I'm going to talk a little bit about the reason behind its popularity, how it's spanned across the entire globe for so long. So just a little bit of an intro to the act. High-fiving actually has a little bit of a formal roots in the low five. Yeah, it's kind of a disappointment, but it was prevalent in the jazz age, and it was made famous in the movie, the 1927 film, The Jazz Singer, when Al Jolson, an American comedian and actor, he slaps a low five to a stranger to celebrate a Broadway audition that he had just done offered. And so this was kind of just the first formal time we saw it on a big screen, and so it kind of sparked the masses to rejoice around the phenomenon of slapping hands with one another. So the first formal high five that is being recognized, there's a little bit of scrutiny about the official origin, but according to the ESPN 30 for 30 documentary, The High Five, it was invented in 1977 when Dusty Baker, a player for the Los Angeles Dodgers, hit a home run and was rounding the bases when rookie Glenn Burke comes up to him, raises his hands, and instinctively Dusty slaps him, and the legend was born. After that, sports players have been known to slap hands after any sort of celebratory fashion. So there's a picture of the snap by a LA Times photographer of the first high five, allegedly. So now we're going to talk a little bit about how it's carried out around the world. So obviously we have the common five, which stems from clapping, and the low five. And so it's carried out around the world to celebrate different actions, whatever positive event that you're going through. We've also seen the emergence of the fist bump in recent years, relatively the 90s to the 2000s. It's a little bit more closed, less welcoming, as you can see by the shape. And so it's a little bit less welcoming, a little bit more individualistic. Maybe germ phobia has also added to that. So people don't want to touch each other's hands. They're more likely to just touch knuckles. This has also led to the emergence of the turkey, which according to Urban Dictionary is when person A comes to offer a high five, and person B goes in for the fist bump, which ends up being a little bit of a turkey. So next time that happens to you, you just gotta call it out and then make the other person laugh or try to get it. So now we're gonna talk a little bit about the progression. So we've gone pretty far from Al Jolson's little slap of a low five on the Broadway streets to now there's intricate handshakes between people, interpersonal connections that are being shared, especially on the sports field. Professionally, we see massively intricate handshakes, such as that of Cleveland Cavaliers here. You can see just massively in-depth handshakes, individualistic with each different person. Oh, there's just the common one. You gotta just make it baseline, but some people you can see they just have massive intricate handshakes, which is a symbol of camaraderie and also of knowing just your fellow teammate. So now we're going to talk a little bit about the reasons for its popularity, which I believe to be its accessibility, its relatability, and its variability. So its accessibility, anyone with a hand can give a high five. And as well, if you may be missing a hand, it's still the same gesture. Basically, anyone can partake in it, and it's a celebratory event. Its relatability, so it conveys a common excitement, this emotion that everyone knows, we're all happy, excited, slap hands, it's easy as that. And then the variability. So we can go from the low bar, just handshake, clapping maybe, to the low five, all the way up to the high five, the spirited knuckle touch with an explosion, bring it back, all kinds of different stuff. Or you could go to the variability all the way up to the sporting events, sporting participants that just have their back and forth, all kinds of dancing gestures, just as far as you want to take it, basically. So that's the three points that I had to talk about high fives, and those were just an intro to the act and a little bit about its origins, how it's carried out across the world, and just a little bit about the progression of the act, and also the reasons for its popularity in our society. So thank you, and go give someone a high five.